So for a molecule with one chiral center, there are two different enantiomeric possibilities, and we're going to want a way to differentiate between them. In other words, we want a way to assign absolute configuration to any chiral center. In order to do that, we're going to use something called the Cahn-Ingold-Prelog Convention. So what we're going to do is first we have to identify any chiral center. So here we can see that there is one chiral center on this molecule because this carbon is connected to four different groups. It is connected to a hydroxyl group, the implied hydrogen, which I'll go ahead and draw right now, a two-carbon chain, and a one-carbon chain. Four different groups, that is a chiral center. Now, what we are going to need to do is we're going to need to assign a priority to each of those four groups, and we're going to do that by assessing atomic mass one atom at a time. In other words, without looking at an extended chain, we are going to see that this carbon atom that represents the chiral center is connected to an oxygen atom, not a hydroxyl group, but just simply an oxygen atom, a carbon atom over here, a carbon atom over here, and a hydrogen atom over there. So because we are going by atomic mass, we know immediately that the oxygen atom is going to be priority one because that is the heaviest atom of the atoms in question. Likewise, the hydrogen is the lightest atom, so that is certainly going to be priority four. Now, it is these two carbon atoms that are equivalent. And if you hit an equivalency, you're going to have to extend further down the chain until you reach a point of difference. Now, this carbon atom happens to be bound to the three implied hydrogen atoms. So that's hydrogen, hydrogen, hydrogen. This carbon atom is bound to two implied hydrogen atoms and a carbon atom, so hydrogen, hydrogen, carbon. Now, one way to look at it is as though these hydrogens cancel, these hydrogens cancel, then we're pitting a carbon atom versus a hydrogen atom, and because carbon is heavier than hydrogen, that means that this carbon is going to get priority two over this one, which will now be priority three. Now, I just want to reiterate what we have just said because this is often a point of confusion. I want to stress the fact that as you assign priority via this convention, you must go one atom at a time. So it is not the case that this is priority two over that carbon because an ethyl group is heavier than a methyl group. That is not the case. What is the case is that they are identical carbon atoms, but then because we have to go one point of difference further, we see that hydrogen, hydrogen, hydrogen in totality weighs less than hydrogen, hydrogen, carbon. So that is why this gets priority two over this. So on the basis of atomic mass, we have assigned priority to these four groups. We have one, two, three, four. In order to assign absolute configuration, you have to place yourself or rotate the molecule in such a way so as to put the lowest priority group away from you. Now, fortunately, in this case, that is already how the molecule is sitting because the number four priority group, the lowest priority group, is on this dash bond, meaning it is further away from us than the board. So just looking directly upon this molecule, we are already in the privileged perspective to be able to assign absolute configuration. If that wasn't the case and the number four group was in the plane of the board or coming towards us, we would have to do something to either redraw the molecule or rotate the molecule in our minds or do some other trick, which we'll discuss later. But for the time being, let's just be happy that that's already away from us. And so now what we're going to do is we're going to make a circle from group one to two to three. So here's one, here's two, here's three. If the circle went clockwise, then that is an R stereocenter. If the circle went counterclockwise, that would be an S stereocenter. So these are the two absolute configurations for any chiral center. Because we have determined that this is clockwise and therefore R, that means that this is R2-butanol. So we already knew that this was 2-butanol based on our knowledge of IUPAC nomenclature. However, now we are able to assign the extended formality of the absolute configuration because this is going to be either R or S, and in this particular case, it is R. Now, you're probably going to have to assign absolute configuration on a number of different kinds of chiral centers, and it may not always be the case that the lowest priority substituent is already away from you. So we're going to have to be able to assign absolute configuration regardless of how the substituents are oriented in space or on the paper. So let's take a look at a couple of examples. For one, let's look at the opposite of the example we just looked at. So this is a chiral center, but in this case, the lowest priority group is towards us. So we are not in the privileged perspective to be able to assign absolute configuration. So there's a couple things we can do. If you are very good with spatial orientation and that kind of thing, what you could do is simply place yourself in a different position in space mentally. So for example, if I was on the other side of this board, looking back this way towards you, then I would be in the appropriate orientation because this hydrogen atom that is projecting towards you right now would then be away from me. And from that perspective, I could see that bromine, ethane, methyl, that would be S, that would be counterclockwise from my perspective behind the board. However, a lot of people are maybe not as comfortable with that, and so there's other tricks that we can do. For example, we can arbitrarily switch the bromine and the hydrogen and place the bromine on the wedge and the hydrogen on the dash. Now, this is sort of a cheat because we're redrawing a completely different molecule. But what we're doing is we're saying that if I switch the bromine and the hydrogen, it is going to be easier for me to assign the absolute configuration because now I can just look at it the way we're looking at the board right now, and we can go like this. That looks like R. So, but the thing is that we have inverted the chiral center to the opposite configuration. So if we do this kind of cheating method, what we're going to have to do is invert the answer we get. So we swapped them. The swapped molecule looks like R. Therefore, the original must have been S. Okay, so we can kind of swap things to make it easier for ourselves, but then we must invert our answer. Because it is the case that if you switch the position of any two groups on a chiral center, you will invert the stereochemistry of that chiral center. So let's take a look at another example here. Now it's the case that the lowest priority group, the hydrogen, is in the plane of the board. So it's not going to work. Switching the dash and the wedge bonds is not going to help because that is not going to be changing the positioning of the lowest priority group. Now again, if you're very good with spatial reasoning, what you can do is orient yourself in a position to imagine that the lowest priority group is away from you. So imagine I'm sitting in the plane of the board and I'm looking this way. Now the hydrogen is away from me and I can see that the bromine is up here. The chlorine is down and to my left because this wedge bond projects the chlorine out this way, and then that fluorine is down and to the right. So I'm seeing bromine, chlorine, fluorine from my perspective. That looks like S. Now, once again, not everyone is comfortable with this kind of reasoning. So what we can do is apply the same rule that if you swap any two groups on a chiral center, you are going to invert the stereochemistry of that chiral center. But if we say, for example, switch the hydrogen and the fluorine. Now, the reason we would do that is because if we place the lowest priority group away from us, which would be the case if it was on the dash bond, that would be furthest away from us. So we can arbitrarily swap the hydrogen and the fluorine like this. And now, simply by looking in the direction towards the board, we are able to assess what's going on. And so we would see bromine, chlorine, fluorine that would be clockwise, so that appears to be R. However, once again, if we do this some kind of cheating thing like this, we have to then invert our answer. So in inverting the stereocenter, we made something that looks like R. That means that the original must have been S. So when you are assigning absolute configuration for a chiral center where the lowest priority group is not already away from you, you have two options. You can change in your mind where you are located and the way you are looking at the molecule, if you're very good with spatial reasoning, or if you are not, you can swap any two groups in that chiral center, but then you have to realize that what it appears to be after you swap them, you must then invert to get the absolute configuration reflective of the original molecule. Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. And as always, feel free to email me with questions, professordaveexplains@gmail.com.